But when it's anything to do with Muslims, they say, oh, you Muslim, this, that.
And then they said Muslim kill people, they're terrorists.
Yeah, that's
no,
yeah.
They're not all of them terrorists. There
exactly.
might be some terrorists, there might
no,
be some of them.
Some.
Of course. So, but then this is the problem, but today, when we talk in general, instead of specific. If I see you doing something, I'll point it my finger. I said, brother, that's not right, don't do that. Why are you doing that? That's wrong.
Yeah.
I can tell you, but if I see him next time, I cannot say to him, you Somalian, that's what you do. Somalian people, you see?
Yeah.
And he will say to me, what? We don't do that. And I'll say to him, yes, let me tell you, let me prove you. I've got this boy, I recorded him, this is what he did.
Yeah.
You see, what happened is that we speak for general.
Generalization.
Which is so dangerous.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's why I said last time I spoke here, be specific. Otherwise, speak for everything.
That's why the brother got angry last time. We're recording, yeah?
Yes.
That's not before.
You got video.
Yeah, we're recording.
So now let's go back.
Let's go back to the conversation you are having.
So what we were talking about is, what we were talking about was about women.
Women.
Okay? And then the reason we came to this conversation is that basically when we talk first about relationship, then we, women do this in this country, they do this to men. Yes, we do. We know that. But specifically, Satan always uses women.
Yes.
Okay, because woman has power. Even in the Bible, woman has power. Woman can make a difference, woman can destroy. A good woman in the Bible, she's loving, she's caring, she prays her husband, she makes him breakfast early morning, and then she goes to the field, she does what she needs to do, she comes home again, she even washes his feet. That's a good woman, the Bible says. But there's an evil woman also, who destroys her husband, destroys her children.
Destroy lives.
Yes. So Satan will use women, okay? He will use women. And I said to my brother, he said to me, there's nothing in the Quran like that about women. And I said, no, there is. Because I read it myself that it says that women, the reason he says that, be careful for women. Muhammad Prophet was saying, be careful for women, because they are come when they come in the form of
Shaytan.
Right, I agree with him.
Women come in the form of Shaytan. Brother, you disagreed with that.
So he said it, but he said no, our Quran don't say that, but I will show him, I'm not lying, I will absolutely show him that yes, it has said, I'm not going to repeat something I didn't see, I didn't hear, it's no good for me, I can't, but I saw it, and I read it, and I can show my brother, because I read it, in fact, I took it out.
We're going to bring that next week, yeah?
I will bring that next week, and I will show it to you.
Okay,
and
brother.
And you will see, and this is in Hadith. So, what I'm saying is that, of course, today, and long time ago, and another thing we spoke as well, is that, about marrying young children.
Yeah.
Okay, I want to say something about that. Okay. You said that you made a lot of points in that, but what I can pick up from that is that on the Christian point of view, the Christians always portray women as evil, as the woman
is evil,
the axis of evil, everything evil that happens to mankind, everything evil that happens to mankind is because of women. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. I somehow agree that Satan can go through women to achieve some stuff, but it's not all the time. It's not all the time. Do you know what I mean? Even in the garden.
Put this one. Okay, so
Yeah, of course. Like Satan can use women, but Satan can also use men.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I know that women is easy for Satan, but men is also easy for Satan. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But the reason why I'm objecting to that is like, because the Christian, they believe that women is the axis of evil, and Satan always used women to achieve his goal, which I think is false. Satan always also used men to achieve his goal. Do you know what I mean? So we cannot betray women as an evil person. Some evil creation of God. For me, that's unjust, and that's not in the Quran.
So this in the Quran.
Not,
so you disagree with the Quran.
So first of all, you don't know where it is in the Quran. You're gonna show me next week,
you
said.
And then,
but you are confused whether it's in the Quran or the Hadith. Because the Quran.
So auntie, madam,
remember,
was it Hadith or Quran?
I think it's in Hadith.
Okay, it's in Hadith, not
Quran. Hadith.
Yes, Hadith. Okay.
So I'm not sure. I did make clear earlier. I'm not sure if it's in the Hadith, if it's the Quran, but Hadith. I record it, even if it's Hadith, I put the number on it as
Okay. So next week, inshallah, if you bring it,
so
we can clarify.
I'm not gonna bring something in my mouth.
Yeah, because you said earlier on that that the Prophet Muhammad, that he lusted, like he watched a woman, he desired. Yeah, that's it, that he desired.
You want to explain that as well?
Yes, I can explain that. I read it there. Muhammad saw the woman passing, and then when he looked at her, he went to Zaid, his wife. He absolutely had sex with her, and he released his pleasure, okay? But when he came back, he said to his companion, he said to them, be careful. When you see a woman, he's right. When you see a woman, especially when you pray, he said to them, be careful, because you can get distracted, you can lust after her. Or if that happened to you, go to your wife, have sex with your wife.
Yes.
What he said to them is he directed them to do the right thing, isn't it?
Yes.
Instead of going with anyone in the street.
Zina,
he's preventing you from zina.
So I wasn't even going to say anything bad. I'm just saying to you, when we talk about women, I mentioned that, of course, the Quran, Muhammad also, he was mentioning these things, he was written.
What I understood, what I understood from the first statement is that the Prophet saw the woman and he desired her. That's what I heard.
Yeah.
Mm. He saw the woman and he desired her.
Because he's a man, isn't he?
No, but he didn't desire her. He didn't desire the woman that he saw. Even if your hadith is right, it's potentially because that's hadith, weak hadith, that strong hadith,
and
that's munkar.
I've never heard
the hadith before. I've never heard of it.
Yeah.
So if you present the hadith and we will check we will check the authentic, if it's authentic or not.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
And you can tell me, maybe lie, maybe somebody is crazy.
Yeah, we can check that. But what I heard from you, he said that the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he saw the woman and he desired her.
And then he went to his wife.
But that's a different desiring the woman that he saw.
Yeah, but bro, you know what it is?
But that's why he went to have sex with his wife, which is he did the right thing. He didn't go after the woman. He didn't rape the woman.
Okay, anyway, that's pointless talking about this. I don't want to talk too much about this because you don't have the number of the hadith.
No, and then,
I would like to read the hadith itself. Because sometimes people just read
the
portion of the hadith and then leave the rest.
Or
they just explain their understanding of the hadith. Do you know what I mean?
Sometimes Christians,
Christians, they do that. They take the hadith and then they will explain the understanding of the hadith.
Out of context. But I don't think auntie does that,
I don't know. I don't know if in this case if she's doing it or not.
No.
Because I'm saying that she doesn't have the hadith, so there's no point talking about it.
I know,
but I don't want to take your word for this because you're talking about my prophet.
I wouldn't
just take it like that.
I know, but you know what it is, though. You see, as a man, you see a woman. You're gonna say, okay, like, she looks nice. You're gonna say, it's complex.
And they even lost, they look at her all the way down, going down there, until she turned, which is for your fault. It is the woman, that's why Muhammad wants the woman to cover. That's the whole idea. Respect for them so that they will not make lust to someone else. That's what covering is
comes.
In that passage, actually, makes clearly that,
That's why they say prevention is better than cure.
I understand the moral lesson behind it. I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying that since she doesn't have the hadith and stuff, because I have to check.
You can't take it from face value. You're saying I can't take it from face value. Is that what you're saying, brother?
That's what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
Okay. Because I need to check the hadith, whether it's weak, authentic,
I want to make comment is when you talk about, like, Christian people, they accuse women. You say that again.
The Christian, they really, like, they accuse women of evil. Like,
do you think they demonize women?
They demonize women.
So now,
and Islam, we don't do that.
Now he's wrong. He said Islam, we don't do
that. Yeah, I said that before.
About
I said,
1.7 million Muslims, he's talking about all of them.
Islam.
You know what you just said there, auntie? Yeah. You said Islam, not Muslims. There's a big difference. Some people don't understand.
Islam's the religion, Muslims the people.
Yeah.
Okay, Islam is the religion.
Yeah,
the religion.
Okay.
So what I'm
saying
is, even for him to say, you don't say that in Muslim, whatever, in Islam, he's still wrong.
Yeah.
Because you know what? He's speaking for the whole...
I'm not going to lie, bro.
Yes, the people that don't even live with them. You don't even know them, most of them. You can't do that. Correct me in that.
Let me rephrase myself.
Wait. You can say my mom don't do that. You can say my sister
Okay, let me rephrase. You get me wrong. You get me wrong.
But you cannot say...
You get me wrong.
He said no. What he said is the Christian think that women
demonize women.
But we Muslims, he said, no, we don't do that.
I said it's in Islam. In Islam, Islam doesn't do that. Islam doesn't. Islam is the religion. Islam is the religion.
But you're wrong.
No, I'm right.
You're not right because Muhammad said it. Woman comes in the form of Satan, which I'm going to show you next week.
Yeah.
So that's even. What
say woman come in the form of Shaytan.
Yes,
woman come
in them, yes.
In the form of Shaytan. Or Shaytan come in the form of woman. Which one is it?
Woman comes in the form of Shaytan.
Woman come in the form of Shaytan.
Yes, so that means
are you listening to yourself? Are you listening to yourself? Women come in the form of Shaytan.
No, you have to understand logically. Look at it.
Okay, you have the proof for that. You have the references.
Of course, my dear.
You don't have.
Otherwise, I wouldn't say somebody else sent to me.
Bring the references. That's really out.
Because I left at home.
You see, if you're a perfect man and you believe in Islam all the way, and you're pious, you believe in the religion, everything, and the shaitan will try to corrupt you, will get inside your mind.
And to all of us,
and they know they don't have nothing to get inside your mind. So what do they bring?
When you say even he does that to men, I agree. 100%.
No, but I cannot understand where you see where the brother's coming from. He's trying to say, does the shaitan come in woman's form? Are you trying to say the woman comes in shaitan's form?
Exactly.
The words, auntie, words have to be true.
Exactly.
My word is that if I'm wrong, I'll prove you from that book.
Okay.
And then I might be wrong. I'm not saying I'm right everything because I'm talking about what I wrote.
Okay.
So it says that for me, this is what I thought. But if I'm wrong, you will see it there anyway when I show you.
Okay.
He said to them, be careful. Woman comes in the form of Satan. Meaning is he uses her to seduce people or to do something. It was his point. And I think I agree with him because there's a lot that I see.
That language is quite problematic because if a woman can take the form of Satan.
I think it's the other way around.
Then that's the problem. That's what I'm trying to say. Do you know what I mean? That's the problem. If a woman can take the form of Satan or Satan can take the form of a woman, that's a big difference.
No, Satan don't take the
form of a woman, but the woman take the form of Satan. So woman has the power.
It's the other way, auntie.
So woman has the power to take the form of Satan.
If Satan say to you, kill this brother.
Yeah.
And then, no, not even Satan. Number one, let me clear this. Satan doesn't do, is it not raining?
No, it's okay.
It's okay. No.
Okay. For example, I have to explain something. Satan is a spirit.
Yeah.
From the beginning, he came to kill, to steal, to destroy. He's a liar. He's a deceiver.
Yeah.
The Quran agreed. The Bible agreed with that. Okay? So now, Satan, you open the door for Satan. I open the door for him.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't open the door for us. His job is when the door opens, even the Quran said, I'm going to show that to you as well.
To corrupt the...
Yes. Even Allah said in the Quran, basically, he said that no one can touch my prophet or my servant unless they open their heart to him.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise I will protect them. God cannot stop us if we open the door for him.
Yes.
Now you said in your home last night, if he said, you know what, this brother, I hate him. I'm gonna kill him. Wallahi, I'm gonna kill him. If he say that, let me tell you something. Satan is gonna bring video in your face, how much you can hate him, how much he can remind you what
and
he
sure,
did, what he said, and then what are you doing? Because you opened the door for him. He didn't say this is my brother.
Yeah.
Even though he hurt me, I forgive him. If you say that, Satan will run away.
Mm-hmm.
We opened the door for Satan.
That,
exactly. And this is true.
Yeah.
I experienced
but you have to understand this.
We
Satan?
Saw that. Satan is that's what he does.
Well, get
and
it anyway.
I agree with him when he said he does that to men as well. Of course he does that to men. Not only a woman. So he will come while you open the door. Even those people that are killing themselves. He tell them all the time, every day, you're not worthy. You're not. But you know what? Look at your friend. Look at your brother.
Yeah.
What are you doing? It's not worthy for you to believe or to
that's
live
true.
Here. That's why they can end up themselves. How can you help yourself? Because he empowered them. Satan empowered us when we allowed him.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yes.
And he's a deceiver. He's a liar.
Of course.
He deceives sometimes many people.
That's
because
true.
He's a liar.
That's his job.
Jesus told us in John 8, he is a deceiver. He is a liar. He is the father of lies. I mean, how clear can Jesus make it more than that? To me, I recognize Satan because of what Jesus taught me.
Can I ask you a question?
Now, yes.
And I've always asked myself here, you see in your Bible, is Jesus more, is he portrayed as a white character or is he more...
No, he never talk about that. He never talk about color. What we know
no,
is
I'm just
a
asking,
Jew.
Most people they say he's white, some say he's black.
He's not white, because Catholic people have pictures in their church.
Yeah.
He's not, doesn't look like that.
Okay.
No one, in fact, no one take a picture. No one take a picture of Muhammad, no one take a picture of Jesus.
Yeah, they're
no
not
there. There was no camera at that time.
But doesn't
we
make
know
sense.
That Muhammad is Arab. 100%, that's why I said 100% last time. Muhammad is not ugly. He's a such a handsome Arab man. Remember, Arab are very handsome.
Thank you.
Very beautiful. Yes, I can imagine. I can picture him with his moustache. Yeah. Imagine with his eyes, with his beautiful eyes.
I don't want to, you know, I just want to make a little comment. You know what Aisha said? May Allah be pleased with her. She said, you know, the prophet that
and I'm not saying this to make you happy.
No, I know.
That's because that's the truth.
Yeah.
Maybe black look like you, but he's still handsome. You guys are handsome.
When they accused him, yeah.
Next Saturday.
Every Saturday.
From 2 o'clock.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's here.
Every Saturday.
Yeah, they come here.
Marble
lights.
It happened yesterday. Yeah, it happened. It did happen yesterday.
Yeah.
But we gotta keep.
Well, it's sad, man.
Your dua.
That's what they need. Now, protest. We protested for a long time.
I'm not gonna lie. You see what it's for?
It's against human kind. It doesn't matter about your religion. Black, you're Muslim,
you stand for this. This is why we need to be at work. I don't know who I am, but I'm still passing through people.
Yes,
I see. I was saying to her that you used to be when I was talking to them. I don't know. We all knew you were here. Maybe have to come for that. God is love. He wants us to love one another. When your children fight, you know, in the house, when they fight, you get mad. I'm a mom, I know, I get mad. Your brother, your sister, you know why? And God is the same. When you fight, everybody gets so mad.
Nah, this war, I don't think it's about religion. It's not about religion, man.
No, it's not about religion, man. I don't know.
God bless you.
Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. What we're saying is that, you see, Sayyidina Williams, al-Islam, like, he was accused of immorality, yeah? And then the woman that accused him, he set up a trap. He brought a lot of women, so he gave them a knife to cut the fruit there. And then he called the prophet to walk past, okay? So when he was walking, they all start staring at him, and then they cut the hand. You know the story, right?
Yeah.
So our mother Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, she said, if those women would have seen the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they would have cut their hearts, not their hand, but their heart, because how handsome the Prophet was.
And you
was
know, so I can picture him.
Do you know what I mean? Just to support what he said.
Yes, it's true. Like, he was Arab. You all agree Muhammad was Arab, isn't he?
Yeah.
So look at Arab people. I love them. Do you know why I love them? The look is so, honestly, I was in love with one Arab man. Long time ago.
Yes, Jesus. You missed a chance becoming a Muslim, sister.
I went, but then we didn't stay that long. For some reason, anyway, he went to prison and whatever.
Prison?
He went to prison
and it's hard.
But they got no Muslims there.
I tried for 1 year.
Now, listen, my point is that, because that's the truth, people can say whatever they like to say. People can do whatever they like to do. But what happened is that people can take picture of Muhammad, ugly picture, cartoon.
Yeah.
Who cares? Yeah. This man, if he's Arab, no, definitely he's handsome.
The Arab, okay? You see the Arab back then and the Arab now is not the same.
Maybe not,
the language,
I don't know.
Everything is different. It's
okay.
Not, it's
but
not.
Now, again, come to Christianity, come to Jesus. Okay, Jesus is certain because Jesus is white or black. That's what I came now. For me personally, honestly, I saw Jesus in my dream. I didn't see Jesus, the one that who...